Hello everybody, it's John. Welcome on back to the shop. Today I'm going to take a little look at some import ER collets. You may have seen a video that I put up before, actually a couple of them, where I had a little less than success with some import collets. They came out of China. They were ER 25, and the long story was, or the short version of a long story was, I ended up having to buy another Mars Taper 3 to an ER 25 chuck that fits the headstock of my lathe. I went through two of those. One of those was the nut would just wobble when it went on, so it was obviously inaccurate. I got another one, thought it looked pretty good. I put the ER 25 collets in it and could get a little bit of success with it. The issue was I had no repeatability with those. I could, you know, turn the collet around in the chuck a little bit and maybe get something, but the reality is they would run anywhere from hardly any run out to up literally to 5 or 10 thousandths run out and with absolutely no repeatability. So that was ended up being pretty much of a failure. Well, I guess I'm a slow learner, so I went and I ordered some ER 32 collets thinking that I would use those in the mill. So I bought an ER 32 collet with an R8 shank on it to go in the mill. So those came in, got them in. It took a long time to get here compared to other things I've gotten out of China. It took almost 6 weeks to get here. Ordered those off Amazon. So let's go to the mill and see what they look like in the mill.
I'm just going to use my phone right here just to show you. What I'm using here is a piece of half inch drill rod that I know is straight. I use that for different alignment here. And that's the half inch rod in the RS, or rather the ER32 collet. Looks like we're swinging between 5 and 6 thousandths. And I'm running that on the low speed here in the milling machine. So that's a half inch drill rod that is a known straightness. It is straight. Let's try another diameter and see. Okay, now I'm using and I've got that thing upside down. I had it on the other one upside down also. That'll give you a little bit better idea. But that's 1/4 inch, and you can see how it's moving all over the board too. So I'm not going to check another one. I don't know what the problem is other than me and my luck with these Chinese collets. But I think they're just about one step away from the trash can. Join me back at the bench and we'll wrap this thing up.
Well, as you can see, pretty disappointed in that run also. I think what happened, and obviously there was quality issues, and I really think what that was just a set of metric collets that they had rebranded over to Imperial. Yeah, that's kind of the case. Just because you stamp them with Imperial measurements, inch measurements, does not necessarily make them inch measurements. So there were things, the half inch just barely would go in, the 3/8 went in somewhat. I think it was the 7/16 I tried. It fit very loosely, so it was obviously these were off size. To go back a little bit about the ER25 collets, I looked at those a little closer after I did two videos on those, and I took a piece of shim stock and in the slits in the collet, you could literally drag through. There was machining swarf that was still left behind, and the problem was some of it was still attached to the collet with a little a hair-like thing sticking off of it. They were just awful, was what it was. I'm a slow learner, but you know, at one time, I've just got to say I'm pretty much just through with dealing with the Chinese tooling when it comes to ultra precision. You know, I might still buy an end mill from time to time or do something, but when it comes down to something that I need precision or expected precision, such as a collet, no more import collets for me, especially from Asia. That's down through there. I hate that. I would love to buy American products. I'm retired. I'm on a fixed income, and my wife and I, we do like to travel and we do like other things. So my shop money is a little bit limited. I try to make it go as far as it can go. In this case, I made a mistake. I've just as easily could have taken $100 and put out in the road and put a match to it for all the work I got. So I've got some ER25 collets, some ER32 collets. I think they're just going to probably end up in the trash because they've been totally useless. I hope you've had better experience than I have, but I'd like to hear your comments about it. So put them down below as to anything that you've had with the Chinese collet to perhaps make them work, or as I suspect, may not have worked. Anyway, this is John. I'll see you back in the shop next time as we continue on with other short little projects here. Until we meet again from one side of a two-car garage in the Upper East Side of Texas. We'll see you later.